Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech and iOS 16.2 Developer Beta 2 released to developers today, and iOS 16.2 Public Beta 2 should be out soon. If it's not out by the time you're watching this video, expect it in the next day or so. Now this came in at 779.7 megabytes on my iPhone 14 Pro Max and was about the same size on all the devices here. Along with this, Apple also released all of the other betas for the other devices: watchOS 9.2 Beta 2, iPadOS 16.2 Beta 2, macOS 13.1 Beta 2, tvOS 16.1 Beta 2, and audioOS 16.2 Beta 2. That's actually the HomePod update's name. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the build number and talk about what's new. So we'll go to Settings, then we'll go to General, then About. As you can see, the build number is 20C5043E. With Beta 1, we had an E at the end as well. However, we should expect a few more betas before the final public release. We'll talk about when to expect that a little bit later. Now this update does have a modem update in it. We went from version 1.21.01 on the 14 Pro Max. With Beta 2, it's now 1.21.05. Now, as far as what's new, well, the first thing is, if you're in India, you now have 5G support on supported phones. So if you have an iPhone that supports 5G, so a 13, a 14, an iPhone 12, you'll now actually have support for 5G. And you can find that under Settings. So if we go back into our Settings and you go to Cellular, and within your cellular data options, you can see Voice and Data. If you tap on this, you can now force 5G to be turned on. You'll have 5G auto and also LTE options. You may have additional options as well, depending on your carrier. So it's great to see that brought to India. Now, if we go to the lock screen and we customize it, let's go and customize, and let's remove a widget here. We now have some new widgets for health. So if we scroll down, you'll see under health, we now have medications. So we can see our scheduled medications for the day. We have a smaller widget as well. And we also have a widget at the very top. So we not only have options for your weather and calendar events, but we also have health as well. So if you have medications, you can actually see them at the top. This is a great addition and great if you use medications all the time. They're just bringing more and more widgets. Last time we got the new sleep widgets with Beta 1. So that's something they keep updating. We'll probably see more of these as the betas continue. Now, when you're customizing the lock screen, also there's something new here as well. So if we go over to Beta 1 that I have on my 14 Pro, we'll bring down the lock screen here or the home screen. We'll go to customize. And if we tap the three dots in the bottom right, you'll see we have a new option for show photo in library. If we tap on this, we can see our wallpaper within the library itself, bringing us directly to that photo. So it's just a nice update to make it easier to get to. Now with iOS 16.1, we gained live activities, but Apple added another option with 16.1 Beta 2. They actually added it back, but if we go into settings and then we go down to the TV app, we scroll down a little bit, we have live activities. That was in Beta 1. When you tap on live activities, we now have a new option for allow live activities and now more frequent updates. With Beta 1, this was basically empty, and you'll see it says allowing more frequent updates lets you see more real-time information but can drain your battery faster. So it's now giving you the option, do you want to see more updates or preserve your battery? So that's something they've added with 16.2 Beta 2. Also, something small in this update is if we go to Settings, General, and then Software Update, you can see it actually says iOS 16.2 iOS is up to date, but this is no longer bold with Beta 2. It was larger and more bold with Beta 1. It's a small change, but just something I thought I'd mention. Now, Freeform was something that was added with Beta 1. This is an app that will be automatically installed once iOS 16.2 releases to the public, and it allows you to have a custom shared screen where you can share whatever you'd like. So you can draw on the screen, leave notes, comments, and everything else, and you'll see it says, "Hi, this is new." I noticed this time around, it syncs much faster between devices. So if we go over to the iPad, we'll go into the iPad, go to Freeform, and let's create a new one here, and we'll just write Zolotech. It's pretty messy, but you get the idea. And let's go back and see how quickly it syncs. Now it synced quickly before, you'll see it automatically showed up and the same Freeform board is already there. So it's synced across both of them. If we go into the pencil and just draw another couple lines here, We'll give it a moment to sync on the iPad and it shows up automatically. So it's much faster than it used to be. It seems like they're improving performance all the time with this. Also, sharing and everything else should improve over time, so it's much more seamless once you're using it. Now, something else I noticed with Beta 2 is how fast connectivity with AirPods Pro 2 switches between devices. So if I open these up, I'll connect them to Beta 1. So I'll just put an AirPod Pro 2 in my ear. You'll see it connects. And it was really an issue for me on Beta 1. Hopefully this is resolved, but let's go ahead and see what it's like. We'll go ahead and play a song. It's connected here. So it's playing a song in my right ear. Let's go over to the 14 Pro Max. We'll hit play. Give it a second, it automatically moves and it's very, very quick. So it's definitely much better than it was before. So this is something I noticed right away once updating to Beta 2. That's great news, and hopefully that goes along with overall connectivity and the modem update as well. So that modem issue, I've been having a lot of issues with the cellular modem, with disconnects, things disconnecting from my car while I'm playing music, and much more. So hopefully that's resolved. However, we don't have satellite connectivity yet. Satellite connectivity is something that's coming later on. It should be available on the 14 series devices, but it's not to be found anywhere in cellular or anywhere else. I looked in emergency SOS and it's just not there yet. It'll probably be added a little bit later or with iOS 16.1.1. We'll talk about that in a moment. As far as bugs that they've fixed, well, one that they've fixed that's very obvious and I'm very glad they fixed has to do with the camera. If you go to the lock screen, enable the camera, you couldn't swipe up and just go back to the lock screen or go home. It was sort of locked and would keep you from doing that. The swipe gesture just wouldn't work. Now it's working as it did before. So that's great news. Also, if we go to the App Store, it seems to be loading much faster. It loads, you can go into things very quickly. You'll see it just pops up and loads as you would expect. So if you wanted to load an app, install that app, it just seems to be much more responsive this time around. We'll have to wait and see if cellular is truly fixed with Wi-Fi and Bluetooth disconnects and more, as well as CarPlay, but it will take a few days to know that for sure. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the release notes. So we'll go into feedback, and within the feedback app, we'll go to recent activity. One thing I wanted to mention before we take a look at the iOS notes is they now have HomePod notes as well. So release notes for HomePod are in here. If you're a beta tester, giving known issues or anything else. So let's go into the notes and you'll see there's some known issues for Freeform. They're still working on it. And there's some workarounds here where you can't delete boards while offline or if iCloud data is disabled for Freeform, and they give a workaround for that. They did resolve an issue with the keyboard with Beta 2. So it says when typing in Chinese pinyin, hopefully I'm saying that properly, selecting an option from the candidate bar is unresponsive. They've resolved that. There's also new features with Swift UI. They've resolved some issues for that as well. So it's great to see them continue to improve this. But of course, we need some additional fixes. Hopefully they've been implemented. We don't know for sure though. Now, as far as overall performance, so far it's been nice and fast. I'll show you the benchmarks in a moment, but it's been nice and fast. Everything's really smooth from ProMotion to older devices. So if we go over to the iPhone 11, we'll load music for the first time, sort of the standard thing I do. We'll let it load. It's loading over Wi-Fi, but scrolling seems to be what you would expect for a 60 hertz display. Everything's loading as expected, and the speed can be affected by Wi-Fi, but definitely it seems to be a little bit better this time around. I did have some hiccups. I had some resprings before with Beta 1. Hopefully those are resolved, but again, that can show up a few days later. Swiping home from an app, sometimes there was lag. Again, it hasn't happened with Beta 2, but hopefully it stays that way. It may show up again in a few days. As far as the heat of the device, it's a little bit warm after installing the update, which is typical in running apps, but nothing that's really hot. It's nice and cool for the most part. It's not hot at all. As far as to touch, it's slightly warm. So that's a good sign. And also as far as benchmarks, like I said, we'll check that in a moment, but it seems to be better than it was before. So just opening apps, scrolling, ProMotion is better as well. If we go into benchmarks, you'll see I had 1,877 for single core, 5,307 for multi-core. I also ran it on the iPhone 11 since I hadn't run it in a very long time, and that had 1,324 for single core, 3,435 for multi-core. If we compare this to the history, if we go back here, you can see in both updates, it seems to be a little bit better. Single core is better for Beta 2 for me, multi-core is also better. So in general, it seems to be doing much better than it was for beta 1 and even iOS 15 versions. So on the iPhone 11, we were running iOS 15.6 the last time I ran Geekbench. So it's doing quite well overall, not really any slower or anything. It feels nice and fast. So that's a great sign. Hopefully it will continue to improve as we get closer to a final release. Now, as far as battery life, we'll take a quick look at this, but this takes a few days to measure. There's no way to know within a few hours, 100%, what the battery is going to be like. You need to use it for a few days, cycle the battery a couple times, and you'll see with beta 1, I didn't have the greatest battery life. So I used almost 50% of my battery and used 2 hours and 37 minutes of screen active time, 3 hours and 9 minutes of screen idle time. So it hasn't been great. Today is a little bit better, 2 hours and 57 minutes of screen on time, 6 hours and 29 minutes of screen idle time, and used about 30% of my battery. So hopefully this is a sign that it's going to get better, but again, it will take a few days to know. Now, as far as iOS 16.1.1 release, well, Apple is definitely working on some issues. In fact, they publicly announced that they're working on issues to solve some issues with their ad network. So that means I would think iOS 16.1.1, you'll see here, it says there is an issue impacting SK ad network for users on iOS 16.1. We are working to quickly resolve this issue in a software update. They also need to resolve the issue with Wi-Fi for many people that they're experiencing with 16.1 and other bugs. So I would expect iOS 16.1.1 either this week, as soon as tomorrow, or sometime next week. Last year, we had an update on the 17th with iOS 15.1.1. We could see it again this week or next week. We don't really know. Apple hasn't given us a specific release date, but I would expect it very soon. As far as iOS 16.2 beta 3's release, usually we're on a bi-weekly cycle, so every couple of weeks. However, they could switch to a weekly cycle, so we could have it as soon as next Tuesday or the Tuesday after. However, I would expect a final release in mid-December, as typically Apple takes holiday break for Christmas and other things in mid-December. So usually that's what happens, as they had 15.2 release last year on December 13th. So I would expect that sort of same rollout this year with iOS 16.2, and we can expect that probably in mid-December as well. So a few more betas until then. As far as AirPods updates, well, Apple updated AirPods Pro 2, Power Beats Pro, and Beats Studio Buds while I was filming this video. I was able to update the AirPods Pro 2, and if we go into settings, we'll go into our AirPods that are connected, scroll down, and you can see the version, 5B58. So that's the new version number for AirPods Pro 2, but they don't say what's actually included. So you'll see it says for firmware details, go in here and see an update about it. So it just tells what the current versions are, but it doesn't say what's actually in it other than bug fixes and other improvements. So hopefully there's more than that, but I just updated them by plugging them into my Mac with a lightning cable. They updated pretty quickly, but you can connect them to your iPhone, plug them in, just set them down, and they'll update automatically. Now, as far as anything else, that's everything so far that we know about in iOS 16.2 Beta 2. And if you're wondering if you should install iOS 16.2 Beta 2, well, if you're trying to resolve an issue, I never recommend trying a beta. However, I would just wait for iOS 16.1.1, and then we'll see how it goes over the next few days with this beta. So hopefully it's going to be much better than Beta 1, more stable and more. But again, it takes a few days to know all of that. Now, if you found anything else, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. And of course, I wanted to thank again Matt, Ryan, and Francisco for your help in helping me find some of the features I mentioned in this video. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.